Hi everyone, here is a small update on this interesting build here. And if we look inside the iRotor here, I've removed the copper windings completely because it was suggested by Matt that there'd be a possibility of the copper wires actually being shorted, which is quite possible. And would cause some problems. So I've removed that, which is a better idea, and takes quite a bit of time actually to do that, and I was surprised. Anyways, got that done, and I now have a prime mover here, which is just a small DC motor, and with this we'll be able to do some much more accurate measurements. And this little DC motor is out of actually a DC Dremel tool. Bit of a toy that you can pick up at Harbor Freight for probably like $10 or something like that. But I made this rubber coupler here, and then I can push this right over the shaft and get a coupling. And what I'll do now is I'll start it up, give you an idea of that motor turning. And there it is turning without it being connected to the shaft. And we can take a voltage reading, that's the voltage, and then we have current there. And what I'm finding actually right away is that this is outputting a lot of RF, and I want to give you a demonstration. Right now I have my scope here, and as you can see I have my mouse moving right over there. So what I'll do, it's moving nicely, no problem, and what I wanted to do is show you that this motor is not the cause of RF. When I make the coupling here and just turn this, and keep in mind nothing will be connected here, or maybe one thing or something, but basically there's no magnetism really in here or magnets, so but there is RF being created, and that's kind of interesting. So let's have a look at that. Okay, so now here it is coupled, and it is now turning that generator device. I don't know what to call it. And right now, actually, I've got nothing connected to the load and scope and all that. And if you look, I can move my mouse really freely, no problem. And all I'm going to do now is connect the yellow terminal here, and that'll go to the tip of my probe, and the ground is the green wire here. I'm just going to connect this one wire. Alright, and now if I try to move my mouse, I'm moving it back and forth very quickly, and nothing, hardly any movement is happening. It's kind of jammed up, and a lot of things get jammed up on the scope, and my keyboard is jammed up. Now let's connect the the green ground wire to the terminal, and we can see there is a waveform. And if we try to get a frequency reading, maybe kind of difficult. I find that kind of interesting, and that's on a 2 ohm load, and I don't know quite well quite why that is doing that. So the other thing that I'll do is I'll introduce a magnet here on the side, and we're going to have a look and see what changes. So now I've added a permanent magnet here, pretty big, 1 inch by 2 inch by half inch thick neo magnet, maybe a N50. So it's polarized, let's say north on the top and south on the other side, and that's exactly there in the center point between these two coils here. And I'll just start it up, and we'll look at the waveform. So as you see, the waveform is much higher, and I would have to try to move my mouse up there. I'm having a hard time. And reduce. I can't click. So I have to stop it to be able to reduce the voltage division. There you go. I was able to do that now. Let's give that a try. So by introducing the magnet, we have a very different scenario. We've got more of a normal, stable frequency. And that's what we're delivering across our 2-ohm load. And you see some kind of sine wave. So that's kind of interesting. And now I can disconnect the, you can look at our data here. There's our voltage, there's our current. I will disconnect the 2-ohm load. 2-ohm load is disconnected. Not much of a change, but a little bit of a drop, very small. And as you see, it's gone. And the RF problem is still there. If I try to move the mouse, it's just moving by chunks. And if I disconnect this again, now the mouse moves perfectly freely. So I thought I would just demonstrate that for now. And I think the next step will probably be looking at creating the a resonance in the coil. Investigate that side. Unfortunately, I don't have any AC tap here where I am, and I would have to get a hold of some AC caps to be able to, capacitors to be able to do some resonance test. So I don't know how long that will be, but there you go. Thanks for watching. Bye now.